This episode is brought to you by me. Seriously though, I'm not big on promoting stuff that I don't personally use and believe in, so instead, I'm going to just quickly tell you about something of mine. Specifically, my fitness book for women, Thinner, Leaner, Stronger. Now, this book has sold over 150,000 copies in the last several years, and it has helped thousands of women build their best bodies ever, which is why it currently has over 1,200 reviews on Amazon with a 4.5-star average. So, if you want to know the biggest lies and myths that keep women from ever achieving the lean, sexy, strong, and healthy bodies they truly desire, and if you want to learn the simple science of building the ultimate female body, then you want to read Thinner, Leaner, Stronger today, which you can find on all major online retailers like Audible, Amazon, iTunes, Kobo, and Google Play. Now, speaking of Audible, I should also mention that you can actually get the audiobook 100% free when you sign up for an Audible account, which I highly recommend that you do if you're not currently listening to audiobooks. I myself love them because they let me make the time that I spend doing things like commuting, prepping food, walking my dog, and so forth into more valuable and productive activities. So if you want to take Audible up on this offer and get my book for free, simply go to www.bit.ly.com/freeTLSbook. And that will take you to Audible. And then you just have to click the sign up today and save button, create your account, and voila, you get to listen to Thinner, Leaner, Stronger for free. Alrighty, that is enough shameless plugging for now, at least. Let's get to the show. Hey there, Mike Matthews here from Muscle for Life and Legion Athletics, and it is Monday, which means it's time for a Motivation Monday episode of the podcast. As you may have noticed, I missed a few Mondays ago, and the reason why is I simply haven't been putting any time into creating these episodes because I am all out on updates to Thinner, Leaner, Stronger first. So this is going to be my third edition of Thinner, Leaner, Stronger, and it's really a rewrite from the beginning because although the basic information in the book is not going to change and not much about the program is going to change, but I am going to do a better job of communicating everything that is in the book because I am a better writer now than when I wrote the second edition. And I also have a long list of questions and suggestions from readers that I want to address along with my own list of things that I want to address to make the book even better. So I am about halfway through what I'm calling TLS 3.0, and then I'm going to go through BLS and create the third edition for BLS for Bigger, Leaner, Stronger as well. And I want to get these projects done as quickly as possible. So I am pretty much devoting every free minute that I have to those projects, and I hope to have both of them done by the end of this month. Latest would be by the middle to end of next month. And until then, I just can't bring myself to do much of anything else because I have an overall timeline of various projects between the different companies, between book publishing and Muscle for Life and Legion Athletics that I want to stick to. And right now I'm really on a deadline. So anyways, that's my excuse for being sporadic with the podcast. But once I get through BLS and TLS 3.0, again, end of this month, latest end of next month, I'll be back on my normal content production schedule, which means the regular production schedule on the podcast as well as the regular schedule on the blogs. But here we are today, and let's start Motivation Monday, as we always do, with a quote. And this one comes from the famous Japanese swordsman Miyamoto Musashi. And he said that it is not difficult to wield a sword in one hand. The way to learn this is to train with two long swords, one in each hand. It will seem difficult at first, but everything is difficult at first. This is a good one to meditate on, to reflect on, because if you are ever struggling to keep up in life, a very effective way to bring yourself up to speed is to take on twice as much as you are currently handling. If you really do this and you do it in such a way that you cannot easily back out, necessity alone will force you, will drive you to figure out how to make it work. But that can be a topic for another episode. In this episode, I want to talk about a simple change that you could make right now that would change everything. everything in your life, your health, your happiness, your fitness, relationships, finances, career, you fill in the rest. And what if I told you that this single factor is what really, at bottom, what really sets extraordinary people apart from everyone else? What if this is how Alexander the Great, one of my favorite characters in history, became the king of the world, how Thomas Edison became the king of inventing, and how Elon Musk is becoming the king of the impossible? And what if this is how you can find out just how special you can be as well? Find out what you are really capable of. What if this is a magic bullet of sorts? Now, what is it? Is it being obsessed? Is it being present? Is it setting big goals, admitting mistakes, or inspiring others? Nope, it is not. It is far more primal than any of that. In fact, without this one thing, none of those things really matter. Now, I have to warn you, though, you're probably not going to like this thing. You're probably going to feel like I am asking you to step out into a blizzard naked, like I'm asking you to force a dislocated limb back into place. So, ready? Here it is. It is simply refusing to make excuses. Refusing to make excuses for every failure, for every shortcoming, for every disadvantage. Refusing to believe that it's okay to give up and take the easy road out. Refusing to look for reasons to be weak. Refusing to blame anyone or anything else for your troubles and for your failures. Speaking of Elon Musk, early on in his career in one of his first companies, he wooed investors by sharing that he approaches life and work as a samurai would. He'd rather kill himself than fail. And I think the life that he has lived so far is a testament to that. For Alexander the Great's part, whether he was sieging a supposedly impregnable city or facing a supposedly invincible army, he refused to believe that he couldn't succeed. He said, "There is nothing impossible to him who will try." And Thomas Edison's take on this? Well, after he had gone through thousands of unworkable light bulb filaments, he was challenged by a reporter about his lack of results. And here was his reply. He said, "Results? Why, man, I've gotten lots of results. If I find 10,000 ways something won't work, I haven't failed. I'm not discouraged, because every wrong attempt discarded is often a step forward." That mindset is power. That is how people do the quote unquote unimaginable. That is the big secret. So what about you? Well, the next time you say you're going to do something, whether it's big or small, don't do what most people do. Don't lard the decision with a coat of maybe, or leave yourself little loopholes or little outs. Don't saddle the decision with ifs or buts, and don't allow excuses to wait in the wings. The next time you say you're going to do something, channel your inner Elon or Alexander or Thomas or whoever you might be most inspired by instead. You're either going to do the thing or you're going to die. And when you can really embody that mindset, you can do anything. Hey there, it's Mike again. I hope you enjoyed this episode and found it interesting and helpful. And if you did and don't mind doing me a favor, then please do give this video a like and leave a comment down below. Not only do I like to hear from everybody and I jump in and reply to as many comments as I can, it also helps other people find their way to the show and learn how to build their best bodies ever too. And of course, if you want to be notified when the next episode goes live, then just subscribe to my channel and you won't miss out on any of the new content. Lastly, if you didn't like something about the show, then definitely shoot me an email at mike@muscleforlife.com and share your thoughts on how you think it could be better. I read everything myself and I'm always looking for constructive feedback, so please do reach out. Thanks again for listening to the episode, and I hope to hear from you soon. And lastly, this episode is brought to you by me. Seriously though, I'm not big on promoting stuff that I don't personally use and believe in, so instead, I'm going to just quickly tell you about something of mine. Specifically, my fitness book for women, Thinner, Leaner, Stronger. Now, this book has sold over 150,000 copies in the last several years, and it has helped thousands of women build their best bodies ever, which is why it currently has over 1,200 reviews on Amazon with a 4.5-star average. So if you want to know the biggest lies and myths that keep women from ever achieving the lean, sexy, strong, and healthy bodies they truly desire, and if you want to learn the simple science of building the ultimate female body, then you want to read Thinner, Leaner, Stronger today, which you can find on all major online retailers like Audible, Amazon, iTunes, Kobo, and Google Play. Now, speaking of Audible, I should also mention that you can actually get the audiobook 100% free when you sign up for an Audible account, which I highly recommend that you do if you're not currently listening to audiobooks. I myself love them because they let me make the time that I spend doing things like commuting, prepping food, walking my dog, and so forth into more valuable and productive activities. So if you want to take Audible up on this offer and get my book for free, simply go to www.bit.ly.com/freeTLSbook. And that will take you to Audible. And then you just have to click the sign up today and save button, create your account, and voila, you get to listen to Thinner, Leaner, Stronger for free.